proud upstart, Tarquinius, Gilberus, the proud king, but one servant to the late monarch Servius. How did Tarquinius reach the throne? By making his own virtue and his will bend to the purpose of the turning evil. In quiet humility he hid his pride, and running to agree with every faction, divided the Roman court till each part sought him as an ally. And those he murdered, more than though a friend had died. If piety impeded him, he'd pray with it. If greed, he'd bribe it. And always he'd pay his way with a prodigious liberality for this coin of secret flattery. So he climbed and married the king's own daughter, whom he murdered. Then married her sister, the self-seeking, self-appointed widow, who's poisoned her first husband, the heir. Once joined in holy wedlock, they throttled the king, and now rule Rome by force, and govern by sheer terror. Quiet their son, Tarquinius Sextus, of whom you shall hear, lead Roman youth to the Etruscan war, and treat the proud city as if it were his own.
This is an axiom among kings, to use a foreign threat to hide a local evil. Oh, hear the grumbling Romans march from Rome to fight the Greeks, who also march from home. Both armies fretting under their own generals. Oh, slowly take now towards the day. This Rome has still 500 years to wait before Christ's perfect death, from which time threats to you descend across the sky. But
here, And Palladius had one. the bed. The Julius is a cackle, the Julius is a cackle, the cackle to cock without the crow. The Julius is a cackle, the cackle, you turn Tarquinius, since you have made the whole of Rome your brothel. My wife and true, but so is yours, for you are married to Norina, the constancy of Thorn. You forget I'm the Prince of Rome, but I at least am Roman. With a negro deputy in bed, it's better to be a Stratton.
Would be To your friends' misfortunes, that you will anticipate your own merely to share them. Dear Calabinus, it is right that we should be friends, for love comes out of loneliness and friendship out of fear. I'm happy and you are miserable, but in a way you're better off than I.
How?
You cannot lose what you have already lost, whereas my heart is so full of joy, it can only spill away. Junius, forgive Tarquinius, and so prevent a silly wager from breaking up free friends, as necessary for the defense of Rome as three lines to a triangle. Tarquinius and I are parallel, we never cross or quarrel. Arm in arm again, Rome can sleep secure. And so I go to bed, good night.
There goes a happy man.
There goes a married man. What makes the Nubian of his heavy mountain? Why does he ravish the rocks of prosperity and powder into dust to find its ear and dust when in his hand he holds a cruel the Roman beyond his remote island? Why do Egyptians dare the shot ferocity and trouble in the deep, wicked dream of sleep? the two is greeted the royal pearl. Is this all his eyes were of the same opinion.
A new year,
I'm honest and admit that a woman's my beginning. Woman's at the end, I'm speaking well. Other than you, when it's your beginning, all to the end, you're speaking. If that's not true, then it's moral, will move. Unfortunate, I, with my untruthful, faithless wife, you, with my barren baby of listless my heart, my heart.
He's up in the earth, God's afraid for his lover's away. For his tools of battle, he's getting into trouble. And for safety, I admit to the feet that my feet run him out of the stable. The man without a curb of cattle, a galleon, so he came back.
Thank you.
Never been a
Oh, look.
character, with that rude politeness which a servant can excel, curtsies and says, "Good night, Your Highness." Whilst Lucia, standing tiptoe in her eyes, curtsies lower than the rest, and finally bids the priest, "Your Highness, good night."
Then Tarquinius, with truly Etruscan grace, bows over Lucretia's hand, then lifts it with slow deliberation to his
through all their arts, their undisputed
But for all their culture, the Romans hated Etruscan tyranny. As Livy tells us,
and show Tarquinius desire, then Tarquinius will dare. The shadows of the night conspire to blind his conscience and pursue desire. Panther agile and panther virile, the prince sees through the silent form. And with all the alacrity of thought, he crosses the unlit gallery, where the bust of Collatinus stares at him with impotent blind eyes. Now he's passing the anchor door. Wake up, old woman. Warm yourself. See how life hides itself. It stands like a sentinel, then moves with stealth. Lucia will hear him. Why doesn't he quench his lust with Lucia and anticipate her assured consent? The pity is that Sid has so much grace. It moves like virtue. Left, Tarquinius!
Thank you. back.
What do you want?
You!
What do you want from me?
Me! What do you feel?
In the forest of my dreams, you have always been the tiger.
Thank you.
and run away, or I must tell. So telling will turn your tender eyes to stone and break your heart and bring the bones of grief through the rags of sorrow. Last night, Tarquinius, ravished me and took his teeth from me, and tore the fabric of our love. What we had woven, Tarquinius has broken. What I have spoken never can be forgotten.
Like a fountain running cool with love liberal, wasteful for his beauty. Is this it all?
it is all.
Romans arise, be yours in custom and done. Here lies the table, be not dead. A life of pain, a bloody shame, our length of body before.
Thank you.
Let me forgive.